Hey everybody, are you working in Power BI? Are you just starting out? Are you struggling to get going? Or have you been working in Power BI for a long time and you just need to get to that next level? Well, today I'm gonna be going over the top 10 books that you should have in your library so that you can advance your career and you can make better content. My name is Chris Wagner. Welcome to Kratos BI. Let's head over into it. Alliance is counting on you. Like, subscribe, leave a comment down below, turn on that alarm bell so you don't miss any future mission. All right, let's get down to what's number 10 on the list of books you need to have. Number 10 is Matt Allington's book, Supercharge Your Power BI. The third edition is out. I have loved my first edition for many, many years. This has taught me so much when I was getting started in Power BI. Matt, thank you so very much for all of your insights and learnings. Really, this taught me about the concept of a golden data set, how you can work together to create a model to solve many, many needs, or potentially even all of your needs. This is just a fantastic book. I can't recommend it enough. I check out the third edition. I am sure it is fantastic. All right, number nine. All right. This book is Extreme Ownership by Jocko Willink. And you said to yourself, Chris, I think I've heard of that book. Jocko Willink is a U.S. Navy SEAL. He has nothing to do with business intelligence. And to that, I say, you're absolutely wrong. The first word in business intelligence is business. And this book talks about how you take accountability and ownership broadly across the business of business intelligence, right? If you work in BI, you the reports and dashboards you make are going to be downstream of any and every change that happens inside your business. And you have to be able to react to that within a reasonable time window. It's through extreme ownership and the principles that are taught in this book that can help you take on that degree of ownership of the content that you're producing and what you're making, all right? So please read this book, take ownership of what goes on inside your business intelligence platform and the work you do, from your data flows to your data model to your measures to your reports. All of that stuff is important and you need to own it, all right? Number eight. All right, this is a brand new book that is recently out. I have gone through this one. This is by Bavik. He used to work at Microsoft. He has a long history of working with enterprise models and establishing best practices when it comes to working with Power BI. This book is fabulous in teaching you all sorts of tips and tricks and secrets that the pros really know that aren't necessarily called out specifically in other places. There, some of them are addressed, some of them are talked about, but lots of them are kind of skirted around, or it's kind of like implied. If I say A, you're going to, of course, make it understand that it also means A, B, C, and D, of course, right? Well, Bavik does a really good job of coming out and explaining all of that stuff. Number eight. Number seven, again, business intelligence is about business. And if you're not making content that your users are using, you're not making good content, all right? The customer-driven playbook is an incredible read when it comes to making a product that your customers are actually going to use. And the users of your analytics are your customers, all right? Make sure you're working with them, talking with them, going through the user experience. You know, as a data professional, you love data. You'll maybe even love data as much as me. I don't know about that, but maybe you do. This book is an incredible way of opening your eyes to seeing all of the different ways that users consume information, or more likely take your reports, and like I've seen this myself, take an incredible masterpiece that you've built out, right? You've got everything just right. You lay it out there and you think it's incredible. And then you look at the usage history and no one's using it. This book will walk you through how to address those issues, how to make sure that the products you're making meet the needs of your users. All right, number six. Okay, this is by Ken Plus and Miguel Escobar. Again, this one goes back a ways for me. I've had this for many years. M is for Data Monkey. This is all about Power Query, right? How do you get your data? How do you shape your data, transform it into delivering the business you know, value that you need, right? The data you're getting most of the time as a business intelligence analyst is not going to be in good shape. It's going to be in all sorts of weird shapes that you have to bring it together. You got to get it into a star schema so that you can actually use the dang thing, right? So that's why number six is master your data, or M is for data monkey. It's all about Power Query or the M programming language. Ken, Miguel, you guys, these books are fantastic. Thanks so much for this. All right. Number five, we're getting to the big ones here. And that's Definitive Guide to Dax. All right. Now, many of you people, if you've been in Power BI for a long time, this is often the number one book people tell you to get. And it is definitively a treasure trove of information. It's got all, I don't know if it's got all the DAX statements, but it is a catalog of DAX statements, at least as of the time of the publishing of this, with examples and demonstrations and all sorts of great information exists in here. Frankly, it is one of the top five books that you should get if you're working on Power BI, because this will tell you anything and everything about what you have going on. There are all the possibilities of working in DAX. This is especially helpful if you find yourself supporting a model that you didn't build, right? And you come upon some DAX that just, what? I don't even know what this is, right? Like,
it's crazy.
But this book can really help you get through that stuff. Highly recommend it. Marco Russo, Alberto Ferrari, these are the Italians. They're on SQLBI.com. They run Dax Guide, the website, and all sorts of stuff. It's a great book. All right. Number four. Now, I bet you saw this one coming. We did M, we did Dax, and now this is a star schema. Your Dax will be much simpler if your data model is in the right order, right? All Power BI data models are a star schema. It doesn't matter what you bring in, or what schema you try to build inside your model. Power BI is going to treat that data like a star schema always, okay? So understanding how a star schema works, understanding how they relate to each other, how you use facts, dimensions, conform dimensions, bridge tables, all of that stuff is covered inside this book. It's something that you absolutely have to have at your fingertips, especially if you're working with complex models. All right, number three. And that is Effective Data Storytelling by Brent Dykes. I just did a book club on this. It's wonderful. It's transforming the way I think about working with data and presenting it to people. All right. This is just a absolutely great book to change the way you think about creating visuals and marketing and getting in the hands of people. All right. It is fabulous. I'm actually starting another book club on this internally at my work, because I think every business analyst or every report author should read this book, go through the concepts that are in this, and try to make sure that you're leveraging as much of this as you possibly can inside of your Power BI reports. All right, number two is Dax Patterns, and I think I threw many people when I put in a Definitive Guide to Dax at number five. And Dax Patterns at number two. When it comes to Power BI and Alberto, Marco, thank you so much. The first version of this book, Dax Patterns. Oh, don't knock over stuff. This is what got me into business intelligence. This is what, I was already in it, but like this changed the way I think about how we do calculations, how we make reports and content. This really shifted my space from working in all sorts of other business intelligence tools over to the Power BI stack. I just love this. And the reason I love these books is because the Definitive Guide to Dax is like a listing of recipe items, right? Like this is flour. Flour is made from blah, 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 right? These are eggs. Eggs come from chickens, right? You need to know those things. That's super helpful. Dax Patterns is the recipe book on how you bake Dax cakes. All right. So if you're looking to actually solve problems and you're in a real world situation, you're trying to work through all the ins and outs and how you deal with all sorts of different things when it comes to like your model or when it comes to your DAX statements or what do you do to get these things to work just right, DAX Patterns is the book for you, all right? This is actually the first book I recommend people to get when they're working inside of Power BI. If they start down this journey, start with DAX Patterns. It is a must have to have inside your library, all right? And the number one is, I find it a little hard to believe that you have to ask it, but you do. And that's Simon Sinek's book, Start With Why, all right? Start With Why focuses in on, in every situation, it's really important to understand the motivations and why you're doing that thing you're doing, right? Be it learning to ride a bike, be it going to school, going to work, or creating a Power BI report. It's really important to understand why are you doing it. Don't lose sight of that purpose. Don't get lost in all the nuances or the this is an issue or this is a problem. Understand what it is, what inspired the situation that would cause for people to ask for this report, right? And honestly, starting with why is something that's really important for you to use in all aspects of your work and in your life, right? Why are you going to work every day and working really hard or watching YouTube videos on Power BI? Why are you doing that? I hope it's because of, you know, like your wife, your kids, your grandkids, your friends, your family. Like you want to better your career to have a better world for those around you that you love and you care for, right? Make sure you keep that focus in place. Make sure that that starting with why and understanding why you're doing these things is at the heart of everything you do, all right? Thank you guys so much for joining this video. I really hope you liked it. If you got something out of it, like, subscribe, you know, leave a comment down below, share it to friends, family members, all that good stuff. That really helps me out and helps me, you know, make more, you know, more better, is that a thing? More better content for you. I hope so. Thank you guys so much. You guys have a blessed day. Peace.